CS students, basic electrical and electronics engineering. The unit 2 we will start. Previous classes we discussed about DC and AC circuits. Now we are going to discuss about DC and AC machines. What is the syllabus regarding DC and AC machines is principle and operation of DC generator, EMF equations, OCC characteristics of DC generator, and principle of operation of DC motor, performance characteristics of DC motor, more speed control of DC motor, principle and operation of single phase transformer. These are the related to DC and AC machines, induction motor, single phase, elementary treatment only required. Now let us start the session with the DC and AC machines. What is meant by generator? What is meant by motor? Everybody knows that a generator is a device which converts mechanical energy into electrical energy, mechanical power into electrical power. Similarly, motor is a vice versa for that. It converts electrical energy or electrical power into mechanical power. That is the motor. Now, what is the construction and principle of DC generator? Let us start in this session. DC generator. A DC generator is a electrical machine which converts mechanical energy into direct current electricity. That is a DC generator. It works on the principle of Faraday's laws of electromagnetic induction. That is dynamically induced EMF it produces. This article outlines basic construction working of DC generator. You can see the principle of DC generator here. According to Faraday's laws of electromagnetic induction, everybody knows that whenever current carrying conductor is placed in a magnetic field, it produces a mechanical force. That is the principle of motor. In case of generator, what is the principle? Whenever a current conductor is placed in a varying magnetic field or conductor is moved in a magnetic field, an EMF or electromotive force is force gets induced in that conductor. That means whenever conductor is moved or magnetic field is moved, anyone has to relative motion is required. Two both does not require to move. One is required to move. That is conductor, either conductor should be moved or flux should be moved. That is the principle of the DC generator. When a conductor is placed in a moving magnetic field, that means varying magnetic field, an EMF will be induced. Similarly, in a conductor moved in a magnetic field, now the flux is constant, now conductor is moving, then an EMF will be generated. That is the Faraday's laws of electromagnetic induction, E equal to N d phi by dt it gives. The minus N indicates it is opposes the according to Lenz's law. The EMF equation of DC generator, that is, the conductor is provided with a closed path, then current will circulate within the path. Now what is the construction of DC generator we can see here. That is the, it is very important for CS students. What is the construction and principle of operation of DC generator? Yoke, the main parts are there, pole and field winding on the stator. For every DC generator will be termed as a two parts. One is stator, another one is a rotor. Every machine consists of two parts, stator and rotor. What are the parts in stator, what are the parts in rotor, that is the important. Now coming to the DC generator or DC machine, either generator or motor, constructionally both are same. We are giving the supply for motor, we are obtaining the supply from the motor generator, for the generator. Now pole and field winding in the stator. Now armature conductors and commutator all will be on rotor. Terminal box is there. Yoke is the main part. Outer frame of the DC machine is called yoke. It is made with cast iron. In case of large machines, it made with another yoke, another material, that is silicon steel laminations we are using for yoke. The field winding is placed on magnetic poles. Silicon steel or Alnico, Alcomax, we are using for poles. And another one is armature. Armature is a rotating part. Armature conductors are placed in the armature. The EMF will be produced in the armature conductors only. The windings are, two types of winding is there for DC generator or DC machine, lap winding and wave winding. In lap winding, A equal to P, whereas in wave winding, parallel paths equal to 2, that is A equal to 2. A equal to P, number of poles in case of lap winding. In case of wave winding, A equal to 2. The commutator converts whatever be the AC is produced in DC generator. In armature, normally AC will be there. Due to the commutator only, by the commutating action, it converts AC to DC. The brushes. Brushes are used to collect the current from the armature conductors and commutator segment. It is a copper commutator segments are used to convert. Okay, this is about construction. Another important one about DC generator is EMF equation of a DC generator. The EMF equation will be obtained from Faraday's law. Faraday's law. Hence, we are assuming so many terms related to DC generator. What are the terms? Is Z is total number of conductors, P equal to number of poles, A equal to number of parallel paths. Now N equal to speed of the armature in RPM, Ez equal to generated voltage, EMF per parallel path, flux cut by one conductor in one revolution is d phi equal to pi p webers, time taken to complete one revolution is 60 by n, EMF generated is pi p n by 60. Now this is the EMF equation of a DC generator. Now coming to types of DC generators, there are two types of basic generator DC generators, self-excited and separately excited. Self-excited, again it is classified into three types according to their field excitation. Field supply, how we are giving, if it is in parallel it is called as shunt, if it is in series field winding, that is a series DC generator. Whereas compound, long shunt compound, short shunt compound, you can see the diagrams how the long shunt is long, and both series and armature both are connected in parallel for the field winding. Now armature is connected in parallel with the field winding only, series field winding is outer, that is short shunt. Only just remember the types of DC generators for CSE students, not in syllabus, but it is important to note the types of DC generators. Now based on EMF generator, based on EMF generator, what is Ez equal to pi z and p by 60a. Now all the details are given. Vz calculated as 178. A 4-pole generator having lap wound armature winding, 51 slot, each slot containing 20 conductors. 20 conductors means 51 slots into 20 conductors, total conductors are 1020, that is 1020 conductors. A equal to p for lap winding. I already told you number of parallel paths equal to poles in case of lap winding. Ez equal to, by substituting all this, z n p by 60 a is 4 by 4, that is 178.5 volts. This is the simple problem regarding to DC generator. This is the another problem, this is not required for you because it is totally back EMF based on back EMF. Here what is the formula we are using? Back current I, field current IF equal to 230 by 550, that is 4.6 amps. Armature current equal to, here we have to remove armature current, it is a generator, it delivers the power, hence it is armature current IA equal to IL plus IF. IL plus IF, armature voltage drop is IA RA 454. Now Ez equal to terminal voltage plus voltage drop, EMF generated equal to terminal voltage plus armature drop, V plus IA RA. V is given as 230 volts, 230 plus plus IR armature drop, we are adding, we are obtaining what is the EMF generated. It is the one formula, and another formula to EMF is Ez equal to V plus IR. We have to remember that one also. Now another term is separately excited DC generator. What are the characteristics? Open circuit and short circuit characteristics are explained here. This is the diagram representing for open circuit characteristics. The characteristics curve which is drawn between field current versus generator voltage, that is called as open circuit characteristics. Open circuit characteristics are magnetization characteristics, these are also called as field current. If we increase the magnetic flux, then only generator voltage increases. At which current, at which voltage, at which field current, the maximum generated voltage obtained, that is called that can be obtained from the graph. Now DC motor, principle of DC motor, how the DC motor works, how it is, principle of DC motor is, again it is a Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction, but Fleming's right left hand rule used to find the direction of force. Whenever current carrying conductor placed in a magnetic field, it experiences a mechanical force, that is called as principle of DC motor. Now what are the purpose of DC motors are using? Multi-purpose application, drilling machines, robots and cranes, excavators, different types of motors are there in similar to DC generators. Shunt to DC generator, shunt to DC motor, series DC generator, series DC motor, compound DC generator, again DC motor, compound DC motor, both are same. Fleming's left hand rule, we have to remember, after L, M will be there. In alphabet English letters, L, M, L after the L only M will come. Hence, left hand rule used for motor. How the left hand rule? Direction of force is indicated by thumb, and magnetic field indicated by forefinger, and direction of current will be indicated by middle finger. Then back EMF. Another important term related to DC motor is back EMF. Back EMF always produces due to the rotation of the armature only. Armature conductors move through the magnetic field and EMF will be induced. Every generator produces the voltage, but the motor also produces a voltage. That voltage is called as EZ equal to EB. We are counter EMF is called as EB. EB is always proportional. The counter always negative sign with the voltage. That is opposes the voltage. The generator voltage, back EMF is a generated voltage in a motor. The generated voltage or back EMF or counter EMF, EB, opposes the supply voltage V. Hence, what is the importance of back EMF is to regulate the current it is required. Current taken by the motor will be low due to the back EMF only. If the back EMF is zero, current taken by the motor very enormous current will be taken. Therefore, we are using starter to reduce the starting current. If the motor is pick up the speed, back EMF will be produced. If the speed is zero at the time of starting, the speed is zero, hence back EMF is zero, hence the motor draws heavy current. To stop the heavy current, we are using starters. 3-pan starter, 4-pan starter, we are using for DC motor. Now, what is the significance of back EMF? I told you, to regulate the flow of armature current, the back EMF plays important role. Next, motor types are again similar to generator. The motors are types shunt wound motor. The direction of current is opposite of generator. Armature takes the current, field takes the current, and supply is given IL, ISH, IL, IF or ISH, both are same. Field current, armature current, line current, it is load current. What is now we are going for discussion about what is single phase induction motor, what is single phase transformer. These are the topics. Again, one more topic is there, speed control of DC motor. That topic is we omitted. So how to speed control of DC motor, we will see now.